Hey guys, it's Dabs here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm excited to share this video with you, and in this video I want to share a tool with you that would be launching into the market real quick. This tool would help you clone literally any website to your preferred page builder, and this page builder include Elementor, Webflow, Bricks Builder, Gutenberg, and a whole lot more. Fantastic stuff here. This website is not launched here. Unfortunately, this website was, as at yesterday, still in beta, and you have the option to create a free account, but right now I can see that option is gone. It's saying 1 day, 11 hours more. I really don't know, maybe this is towards the official launch of this website or still going to continue the beta. If you scroll down here, if you play this video, you see exactly what you can do with this website, but I would be showing you, so there is no need watching that tutorial. Quite a number of things here. They have amazing pricing plan here, which has a free version that can give you about 3 exports per month, and also a paid version as well. I'll be talking with these guys. I'll be seeing how I can get to use the platform and how I can give you guys an amazing deal if this platform is already launched. So that's it. You can continue and see real reviews from people who have experimented. I was able to create a beta account yesterday on this platform. So like I'm saying right now, I'm not sure if this is the official launch, but I have asked the developers questions about this and they've not gotten back to me yet, so I really don't know exactly what's going on here. But I just want to show you what you can do with this tool, and I'm really excited about this tool, and I hope you too would be. For you to be able to use this platform well, you would need a few things. You need to have Elementor, most preferably Elementor Pro. I experimented with this platform yesterday. I did a clone of several websites with the free Elementor. I see that some of the elements were not converting accurately, while some would, but with Elementor Pro, I have gotten the best result. I had access to an interface like this, so you can say my account is not upgraded, and it will tell you to add their Chrome extension, which is very, very important because that's exactly what you would be using to do the clone. So you can see here, I experimented with cloning elementor.com page and it came out very, very beautiful. So as you can see here, but what I would do is to come back here and then I can add another page. I can just call this clone and then I can create this project. You can see now I have this project here, the clone that I just did right now on Elementor. Let's even try to clone their own official website. Let's see the result we would get. So if we come down here, if you install their Chrome extension, you will have this blue icon here. So you can see if you click it, so it will launch up. You will see the clone web X here, and then you can select the project you want. For me, it's the clone that I just created right now, and I can just hit the add to page. But before you do that, what you should do is to make sure you scroll to the page, every of the page, to ensure that the page has been fully loaded. So once you do that, you will see that it will load up this experience. So as you can see here, we have the clone of their own website. Isn't this amazing? So you can see here, fantastic stuff, really cloned within split seconds. This box here gives you options for your clone. The first is to choose whether or not you want to clone certain elements on the page or the entire page. I'll come to that real quick. And the next thing here is your preferred page builder. So you can see Elementor Pro is written here, starting from 3.10 or higher, and then you have to make sure that you activate the flex container, which is activated by default if you are using Elementor Pro. But if you deactivate it, you need to activate it for you to get the best results. And also you can see that you can clone this page to your Webflow, to your Bricks, to Oxygen, to Breakdance, to Gutenberg, and these ones are coming soon. How amazing is that? Let's experiment with Elementor, which is the pro, which I love. You can reduce the DOM size. I've not really worked out with this. I will experiment more and get back to you. And then you can see that we can get the tablet, which is more like the web view and also a mobile view cloned altogether. This would be in their paid future once this is officially launched. Another thing you can still do here is for you to choose how you want to export it. But add it to export data is the best for you to clone both the website, the CSS, the JS and everything. But if you want to copy it to site, you maybe don't want to copy some of the CSS and you want to style it yourself. I've tried to work with both. They all worked out fine. But if you want to clone the website, everything, you just need to leave this as is. And what you want to do is to hit the export button here. But again, you see, say please enter a CSS selector, and that's us selecting which aspect of the website we want to clone. So let's come back to that. So once you go to on the clone website, you can see that once you move, it begins to select whatever you want to clone. So you can see you can easily select this, and you can use your inspect tool for you to select adequately which element of the website you want to clone. But one thing I like is if you come down here, if you over around this, I just love to clone the entire website once off. If you click this, you would see that it would open this box here for you to select what you want to clone. This tool is showing you the element you just select, and then this will be the entire page. This is the parent selector, this is the current selector. I like this feature for you to be able to toggle this on so that you can see which element you are about to clone. But for the purpose of this example, I will just go the parent selector route, which is me cloning the entire page. I'll click this, and then I have smooth wrapper. I hope that's the page there, and I will click the export button. And that's literally everything I need to do. So you can see this has been copied to clipboard. I can then go back to my website where I have WordPress installed. I have Elementor also installed. So for the purpose of this example, I have a demo website here that I have a demo Astra team installed. I have Elementor installed and Elementor Pro installed as well. So what I will just do is that I will come down here, I'll right click, and I'll click paste from other site, and then it will tell me to press Ctrl plus V if you are using the Windows. If you are using a Mac, it should be Command plus V. So that's it. So I've done that right now. So you can see this is pasting. This might take some few seconds depending on how large the page that you are trying to copy is. But if you're just copying a little element here and there, it will just be as fast as the speed of light. All right. So we can see this is popping up already. And isn't this amazing? So you can see here, you can see that this is pretty much loading. How fantastic is this? So you can see this is popping up. We will give this some time to propagate. All right. Okay, so that's it. So we can see, isn't this amazing? This is literally their website here. We have cloned into a new Elementor page builder here. How fantastic is this? How fantastic is this? This is taking time, so you can see this is not looking like it's loading well here, but some of this element may not load at the back end. I don't know if this video will play on the front end, but we'll experiment. Every element here is editable. We can edit this with Elementor, we can change text here and there, but I don't want to do that right now. I just want to update this page. Let's see what this page will look like as a finished page. Alright, so we have this updated already, and as you can see here, you can see that the page already is, or the video right now is already loaded here. So now let's try to view this page. Amazing. As you can see here, the same thing we have here on their live website, we now have literally cloned right here. So now you can see, the video here, and you can see just with a click of a button, isn't this amazing? So you can see this is fantastic. I like this. This is a very, very good tool. This is a promising tool. So I will keep an eye on this tool, and definitely I will be doing more tutorials about this tool when it is officially launched. So you can check them out. I will leave the link to this tool in the video description. You can come down here and check if the beta will continue after this timeout, or they would be officially launched. You may be watching this when Clone WebEx is officially launched. I would also be discussing with them about getting the best deal for my community when this tool is officially launched. So keep an eye on this tool. This would increase your workflow. This would help you literally clone websites and then easily edit them using Elementor. If this video has been of immense value to you, give me a thumbs up. If you're excited about these possibilities, let me know in the comment section. And that's it for this video. I will see you in another one. And until then, stay safe.